Good afternoon, everyone in the room. So today I'm going to present is the Susurit of Latin.
Database. Thank you very much, everyone.
Hi everyone, my name is David. I have a boring day job in a local GLC, but I do freelance software engineering during my free time. So what I developed today is I was looking at trying to make payments in the Southeast Asian region and Asia Pacific more convenient and more user-friendly for both retailers and customers, and trying to leverage upon telecom industry. So looking at the current age payments, we have things like NFC, Square, Apple Pay, Android Pay, and yes, they're very interesting things. I remember the first time I made an Android Pay payment, I was pretty amused with myself. Like when it started beeping, I was like, oh, this is pretty cool. But in the Southeast Asian region, we are looking at low uptake, especially in this part of the world, where NFC phones are not common yet, where retailers are unwilling to spend on CapEx to convert their machines into NFC terminals, and where there's not yet a real push in this area. So for example, I think Square just came into this space, it started NFC payments in Singapore in like April this year. So it's gonna be another few years, especially in this region. So how can we enable users in C and Asia Pacific to make and receive payments with ease? So what I wanted to do today was to leverage upon the telco industry and Axiata's payment API as well, and also to enable anyone to make payments through QR codes and bots. Because the telco industry is very interesting because it has verified access to your phone number, and at the same time, it has a means to conduct billing. So that opens a very unique opportunity in terms of making. So a brief overview of how it works. I opt to use a bot-based interface, and this allows you to generate QR codes. And from there, customers can scan the QR codes and confirm their payment. And finally, retailer can verify the payment and facilitate exchange of goods. So I'll jump to the demo. For example, the bot. So the interaction sequence, the flow would go through something like this. So you start by interacting. And prompt for payment code, and you reply with your item description, for example, chocolate brownies. So there it prompts like the cost. Yeah, so from this system, and then from any phone without using a specific app, as long as the QR reader, you can just scan it, you'll open a URL, and you will come to a page where you can confirm your purchase by entering your phone number. because that's linked to who's getting billed. So I enter the phone number provided by Axiata, click make payment, create a post request to Axiata's API, and I get a successful purchase. So that's basically the sequence to go through. A bit more of the underlying details. So there's a post request ongoing. And also, how do we verify that it's the correct customer? My suggestion at this stage would be probably to send the class 0 SMS, which basically leaves no trace on the phone other than authenticating the user. And there's a lot of things to be done. Like, for example, what if the post request fails? What if the user is not on the Cellcom network or doesn't have enough credit? There's a lot of things to explore there. And then that's the full flow. And why this? Because it provides an accessible and low barrier means of entering payments. QR codes, nothing very ad specific. Even on the retailer side, it's easy to generate, easy to create. And also it leverages upon telcos, because telco has this special relationship with owning the number and knowing the number's identity and being able to build upon this. And it's low tech and low barrier for the Southeast Asian region. Thank you.